Hey guys, so we have just watched New Nightmare. This is a movie that Mark has been building up for quite some time. Least to say, it's different from the entire series. Yeah. It is nothing like the other movies at all. For instance, two people die.
Yeah, there's only two deaths in this movie.
And it's...
Oh, I guess technically there's four, because the other two special effects guys
that die in the beginning dream. Oh, yeah, technically, yes.
But you don't really find out they're dead till like...
They die off screen, technically.
Well, they kind of die on screen. Well,
they died on screen, but their deaths were just a dream, but then later on in the movie, they actually die off screen. But it's also almost 2 hours long. And I think that's one of the issues I have with this movie. It is way too long. Especially when we are spent so much time with Heather
Langenkamp.
Who does an incredible job at acting bad as herself.
It's still probably her best performance of the series.
Well, yeah, it's not. Well, yeah, I'll do that. But it's like, a low bar. Well, it's like when 50 Cent did his Get Rich or Die Trying, and he was terrible as himself. That takes a skill. That takes skill.
But this movie, I mean, the first and foremost thing you have to mention. First of all, Heather does not play Nancy, exactly. Heather plays Heather Langenkamp. This movie is like the most meta of meta movies ever, and it's like it came out in 94, which is like before Wes Craven did Scream, before all that changed. And it's, I love how meta this movie is. The basic premise of the film: Freddy Krueger haunts the cast of the original Nightmare on Elm Street movie while they're making another Nightmare on Elm Street movie. Wes Craven's in it, rest in peace. It's actually kind of sad. There's a whole scene where he does like a little monologue talking about like the death of characters and the death of like one's creations. Mm-hmm. And it is a little sad.
Yeah, it was actually really sad because you could see that he had like, he was a soft-spoken person.
Yeah.
And just hearing him talk about it, just because he's been dead for over 2 years now, it was actually, the scene had an unexpected sadness to it.
Yeah, it was a little, bummed me out a bit too.
That had Rob Shea.
But it's got Bob Shea, it's got Lin Shea shows up again.
Italian-Mexican
guy. Yeah, the Italian
guy.
Dude Tuesday even do night.
He literally, they just did a headshot of him.
But John Saxon's back in the movie.
Oh yeah, Dad, I'm not dying again. I'll admit that, if I'm correct, this is one of the first movies that really did this whole acknowledging that the whole idea of a film life, like putting a movie within a movie.
I'm sure it had been done before, but it's the first time, especially with horror, that it really went that way.
It goes way further than it would expect it to. It's actually kind of disturbing at how well it goes. It does this, and just that's one thing that kept me going throughout the whole movie. It's like, whoa, all these meta images, like all the little hidden parts that are thrown into the movie from previous films, all the characters coming back.
Yeah.
Especially how the movie morphs into a movie at the end.
So she goes through this whole thing and all these things happen. They have a lot of cool throwback moments, like the babysitter gets killed and dragged across the ceiling in a rotating room like Tina in the first movie. They get to a point where she gets back home and John Saxon's there and she's, oh, John, you gotta help me with this. And to the, like, if you're paying really close attention, he says, Freddy Krueger killed my husband. And he says, yeah, sure. And then you don't get that's a callback right away.
Mm-hmm.
And then he calls her Nancy, but he does it like leaving. It's kind of subtle. You don't really notice you're not paying attention. And it's really cool the way they just kind of all of a sudden you realize they're in a movie, in a dream, and it's like super Inception-y dreams.
Oh, yeah, exactly. There's definitely some Inception moments. However, that novelty, I guarantee, is not there as much on the second viewing, on a repeated viewing. You haven't seen this in...
Yeah, it's been a long time since
exactly,
I've seen this
movie. That works for you, but I swear, if we were to watch this like a month or two, definitely like a month from now, there's no way this would have been as enjoyable. Like, that's the problem. It uses its novelty to its advantage, but at the same time, it's such a rare kind of novelty. It's like a twist ending in a movie. Yeah. Especially a movie that relies so heavily off of a twist. Like, say the rest of the movie isn't really that great, but the twist in it is pretty decent. that's what happens. The rewatchability is diminished entirely. And that's what I feel for this movie. This movie has some really cool elements, but it, honestly, when the ending, when we came to the ending and Freddy's chasing her kid, and I said to Mark, What's actually happening? Like, what is the point of this? He's like, oh, there's really no point. And there isn't. There's really no point to what he's doing.
I mean, apparently Wes Craven gives the motivation that
he's a demon.
He's
right?
a demon that that got trapped in the movies in the Nightmare on Elm Street series, and since 91, when the movies ended, he was just kind of wandering, and he started coming into the real world, but still being Freddy. And the only way to stop him is to make this movie to contain him again.
So it's kind of. It's kind of like a ring thing, like keep the thing going,
keep it going or whatever. Okay. And I mean, it. I don't know. I won't get too much. I really do like this movie.
I love the idea.
I like
of it.
The changes in Freddy. I thought the Freddy makeup.
Oh, the makeup
is
so
super cool. It's like a new. We actually get two new claws because the first one, the metal one, that's really cool.
Yeah, that one.
That does
cool.
the like. Adam's family cousin. Yeah. Is it cousin it or is that the hairy one or is it Thing?
Thing.
It might be Thing.
Yeah, Thing.
Anyway, the hand, it runs around, and then we get his like bioengineered hand, which is like it's super cool, like bone that, coming up. Yes. Like it's a very cool.
That was a cool thing. I'll admit that was cool, and also I actually liked Freddy in the trench coat, not with the hat.
Yeah, he didn't like the trench coat. Well, and the hat,
with it, when he had he looked like a senior citizen walking around with some butter knives on his hand, but. Otherwise, I liked this movie. I liked all the elements that it tried. I just couldn't watch this again with the same sort of interest. I would definitely rather watch one or three over this one.
One or three again?
Because that's the thing, too. There's almost no special effects in this movie.
Yeah, there's...
There's terrible CG.
We get a little bit of CG.
That's awful.
I will say another cool thing they mentioned, there are earthquakes feature a lot in this script.
That's cool.
And it was shot right around the time of a big earthquake in LA, so they actually like have footage of their like the movies
super
post the like movies post earthquake footage is
super,
real earthquake footage.
Yeah, super.
Which makes it even more meta.
There's some good scares, but the lack of special effects, which is what made these movies so good.
Yeah.
The kid is derpy.
I was
he
just
got
thinking
better.
About talking
he got,
about
he got better.
Nico Hughes is great in this movie. He's a kid, and it's the first time in this series we actually have like a legitimate kid that Freddy is going after. The guy who plays her husband can't act.
No, he's terrible.
he was not very good. He's super wooden with his lines.
No. Like,
and it's fun seeing Robert Englund. As Robert Englund.
Oh, fuck, with the glasses, and, like, the Bono
he's
glasses.
He's got these Bono glasses. And, like, even the first time when he's the Freddy and he's doing the crowd thing and he's running
he's
around.
Like,
which, like, you know, he's probably like. You see him in interviews and other and things like that. He's super jovial. So it was fun getting to watch him. It was fun watching all these people get to play themselves in a movie. And, like, they bring in a few other kind of, like, meta things to it. One of the storylines is... Heather Langenkamp in the movie has a stalker, which is based on the fact that she really did have a stalker in real life, and Wes Craven asked her if she could put it in the movie. I will say, I think I felt the time a little more this time around. It's probably the fifth time I've seen this movie.
And it doesn't help that we got off of work about at midnight.
It was a long day of work. But, I do like this movie. I think it's well done. I didn't remember that there was this few deaths, which is a good thing, I guess, because I remember the movie being kind of scary, and they have a good jump scare with the closet.
The closet, yeah.
Which is a great moment, and the special effects at the end of the movie are cool, where he does the, like, Beetlejuice
huge mouth thing. That was spooky. That was spooky, but the problem, just my main issue is that how long it took to get there. And then the novelty of the whole thing was starting to wear off on me. I like the idea. I'm not a fan of the idea, but I appreciate what he was trying to do with this.
And I don't know. I just, it's such a unique idea in horror. Like this type of thing doesn't happen very often.
No, God, no.
And it definitely doesn't happen with someone as adept as Wes Craven. Like,
I've seen
other movies that do the whole movie within a movie and things like that.
This is different. Like, I'll give it that. It's totally different from any of those other productions. But in the end, Well, for ratings, I think this is the first time we're going to be really different, but I would give New Nightmare a 4 out of 7, my rating.
It's still my second favorite in the series, of the main series, not including Freddy vs. Jason. And I probably like this movie as much as I like the first one, honestly. But it's as revolutionary as and all that, it won't ever have the staying power for me that the first one did. But I'm still going to give it a 6 because
dang.
I really like this movie.
This movie. Oh, yeah. So that now leaves one more. And I keep forgetting we are going to do that one, but that means we are going to do the remake.
The remake.
Yay.
Which starred Jackie Earle Haley.
Jackie Earle Haley, and the first time we're going to see someone play the nightmare version of Freddy Krueger that isn't Robert Englund, because we've seen a couple kids play him now. But, and it's got a lot of like, what's her name? Chick from Arrow.
I don't know. Whatever. It's got some.
It's got some local actors. Some like
I'm
people
interested,
are out here all the time.
I'm interested to see
people I've met
if it's worse than Freddy's Dead.
Oh, dude, the CG alone's gonna piss you off.
Oh fuck! All right,
it's probably not worse than Freddy's Dead.
No, okay, that would be hard to do. That'd be hard to top.
But I do like this one. This redeems the series for me.
Oh,
it's
yeah,
a great
definitely.
Way to end
ends,
the series.
It ends it on a positive note. I'll give it that.
And I mean,
not the remake,
Jason,
New Nightmare. Just
New
clarifying
Nightmare.
That.
I'm not going anywhere near the remake.
All right, guys. So we will see you when we do the new. The remake of Friday, Freddy. Holy crap, I'm tired.
He only fell asleep once this time, though.
Yeah, once. And just like for like 10 seconds. Anyways, and then we will decide what we do next.
I want to do the Friday series.
I do too, because I actually have never seen any of them except Jason X. I don't know why.
That's literally the worst way you could watch it. I really want to see the Friday movies. Let's watch the worst one in the series. And then after we do all of Friday and the remake of Friday, which
then
I don't hate.
We will get to Freddy versus Jason. So that's probably 2019.
Yeah, somewhere very far away. Thanks for sticking with us this long.
Thank you.
We appreciate it. And we'll see you later.
See you guys later.
Cue the music. Subscribe, bitch!